Hello everyone, this is House of Cores Qualifiers Week 2, Dynamo versus FlameBreaths. Great battle. Actually asked for us. I feel so. I also feel there'd be there, but I feel so loved. We're always ready though, because we always got on these servers first, because we're Oh, so as I was saying, YouTube people, sorry for getting distracted by Squishy. This is Dynamo versus FlameBreaths Qualifiers Week 2. I think they both won. Did they both win last? I'm not sure if they won or lost last. But they both have the same record. Should be fairly even matched, as most of the matches have been this week. Don't know what else to say. Each team has three objectives. Two monuments, only the endstone part though, and one, one core. Lava has to leak out. The teams are trying to get to the other one while the other team is getting back over. There's some key points in this match, like these diamond blocks, and there are also many sky bridges. Stuff like that. Various things like that. Being interesting to see. I'm gonna watch FlameBreaths. Early. We have an early cannon aimed at the monument. It's being watered though. Early cannon battle here. It looks like Dynamo is going to win this one. If they fire this one right. Oh, definitely. Perfect shot. And on the side, they also win that first initial. Ooh, there's an unwatered spot. See? Oh, there's a spot. Excitement didn't last very long that time. Over here. It's the double wide staircase. Oh, one's a railing. Stairwell to nowhere. Nothing new, I don't think. No touches. I don't think anyone's gone on to the other team's side yet. Ooh, we have a sky cannon. A whip cannon? Yeah, whip cannon above the core here, also protecting that defender, and also potentially harassing the defender over here. There's this Edwin MX. Ooh, big hit into there. If they continue this, they may not be able to get any good watering. I'm not sure it'd be killer when it come gold. I assume they should be able to get some. Good thing this here is watered, as that whip cannon is totally destroying this area. Oh! Managed to get some of this, these supplies. Most are being picked up, probably testing back in spawn. That's a lot of noise. Well, that front line is down, including some diamonds on both sides. A lot of diamonds are gone. Ooh, damaged monument over here. Let's see how this ends up. I Naomi underscore I Naomi, that is. I'm confused with the real I. Are you the imposter? I Naomi. Sorry. Getting massive chunk out of this. Is this gonna be the entire one more block? Oh, does not get the final block. Spleef on it. Oh, now it gets the final block. A diamond armor rush early on has paid off for Dynamo. Trying to cut off the defender. Ooh, does a quick jump over. Very effective. Block rush. Ooh, gets in stuck in water near void. Let's see. Yeah, I think this might be the end for this run. Maybe. That's ground. Only so much damage. Naomi can take it. Naomi? Naomi? I don't know.
Exactly sure.
About that. Pronunciation. Flame Breaths have advantage over Dynamo over here on the Sky Bridge. Trying to take out this pillar, Dynamo's pillar. And maybe we'll try to harass this whip cannon. It's really really hurting the defense here. Looks like they do have some defense up, and that defense is gone. Well, it does leak out. Very minimal. And what is happening over here? Anubis gets something. There is... Alright, so, I'm just gonna say that this bedrock here used to be what is right there. That's the amount of difference of destruction between these two teams. Dynamo has a completion and a touch. Flame Breaths only have a proximity. Touch for Flame Breaths. Loban Ho GG getting it. Looks like he just ran up once and is now coming in for a second round. Ooh. Looks like he's gonna get quite a bit. Except he's ran out of air, it seems. Ooh, and he fell into the void. Oh. That's killer.
Tried Spotify on mobile? Download the free app and you can take the music everywhere you go.
This Skybridge has been fairly... Looks like it stopped by their own team. Flame Breaths. Looks like they accidentally hit it when trying to take out this pillar. Sure though. See how this whip cannon's doing. Whip cannon's continuing the harassment. There is very little underwater. We could see what we saw in what breaking gold finals is that Game 1's core was not ready for gold core, and this entire area got blown up. Lava leaked out the bottom. Hopefully not seeing that. Hopefully for Flame Breaths not seeing that. This utter harassment is stopping any sort of underwatering. And then maybe that cannon can get the under kill. However, if they are not able to get the core now, they may never, and then it'll have to go another 60 minutes. I got run around. Carpet bombing by Flame Breaths. trying to take out some frontline area. Some tried to drop into the core. Ooh, did succeed. Looks like they weren't gonna fail there. They're not gonna be very successful against the diamond guy though. Over where is this? Garkin is creating quite a lot of water up here. It'll be very hard to unwater this. But remember that this is easily pickaxeable. It's also very clean right now. And I assume this water's going to go down, yeah. Random pillar / staircase. I don't know what that was intended to do, but. Useless carpet bombing. People falling from the sky. Pretty successful match so far, you know. Let's go up. FlameBreaths are really focusing on carpet bombing. However, they are getting mildly distracted by, I think they should focus a little more on bow battle and be a little more organized in their bow battling. And not kill each other. Ooh! What is that? Oh, arc right here. When that's nice to it, it stops the TNT. But and you can upload from the side, but Art Cannon here took out this diagonally. Very, very interesting. Haven't seen that one in a while. Over, let's see. We had a lot of TNT spamming over here. But surprisingly, this side is still intact. Have they watered underneath the core yet? They have. They'll probably be. Maybe. TNT can easily go off right here and explode it. We'll have to see if that whip isn't still firing. It's not getting under enough. If they get a frontline cannon like there that fires very flat and fast, I think they may be able to leak it. Or, let's see, does. Dynamo does not have skybridge progress, so it's not like they can drop down here and get it. And that's plugged up. Well, it was an idea once. Not the once. I'm making villager noises, but I don't know what to say because nothing's happening. I haven't seen this in a while. Well, I've seen glass all around it, but it looks like they just put glass on the top of the blocks so people can't do the pressure plate TNT trick. Personally, I think crafting tables would be better in this case. You have to shift to do the thing, and you can place other blocks off of it. Ooh, touch on the core for Dynamo. Let's see, where's that from? Side? It's Alvaro. He's on his own side. He's probably the whip cannoner. Got it on the back there. Yeah. Not bad. Not bad at all. There's just a hole in the center of this thing. It's not very effective in terms of stopping TNT from going through. Is this under... Ooh! Touch on both sides for the core. And this is wide open. But, hold on. Let's go check. TP Nico G. Yeah. On his own side. Wait, no, he was killed. That's why. Missed it. Probably with the TNT thing. So, both teams have a core touch. They're equal on their right monuments. However, they're equal all around except on the left two monuments, where it's total opposites. Dynamo with 100%, and FlameBreaths with 0%. So, if you know, just ignored the yellow monument, it would be a fair game. Or equal game, not necessarily fair. FlameBreaths can continuing to push the Skybridge, which is it's really been hurting. Probably that's what led to the touch here, because, you know, jump down and get that easily. And it may lead to this amazing whip cannon here. The whip cannon that's helping both of these teams so much. They poop their own bridge, that's not good. Not both of these, that one team. Sorry. I'm tired. This is my sixth match to commentate today. I haven't really had a break. I took a small break. Not really any break. Not expecting that. A whip cannon. Frightening thing. Don't use whip cannon. Okay. I'll go check. Open these. Please start me. Please start you. I'll check again. Maybe it just wasn't. I still have fun, yeah. Alright. Time to head over here. FlameBreaths really wants the Skybridge. I don't know why. Not giving them that too many advantages. Except maybe carpet bombing this whip cannon, which has been destroying them. FlameBreaths yet to get any new touches. Ooh! FlameBreaths just got another touch. Let's see where that is. Somewhere down here. Trying to funnel it, ultimately failed. However, quite a lot to clean up for the defenders. 45 minutes left in the match. No core leaks yet, which sadly means that we're probably gonna go all 60 minutes long, and then I will have to commentate the entire thing. Because I'm really tired right now. But I guess I will. So, FlameBreaths are going. They're continuing the Skybridge. They have the nice curtain that goes along the side here. Pop an enemy people on. That it's hard to destroy from this side. However, this side is wide open. I don't know what's up with that. Ooh, I'm Naomi, right monument for Dynamo over here. Massive amounts. Relatively, that is. Just taking out all the center. And that's. There goes Naomi. However, 63% of the right monument's pretty decent. Secret live streamer. All right. Arc cannon destroy. Not really destroying any much. Any much more. Probably if they put a double ladder on there. Make some stuff go boom, but. Really, an arc cannon, like, frontline arc cannon right. Hey! Right here. Looks like there used to be one. Well, slightly over to the right more would also be good, but. Could get this, would be very effective. Very, very good for Dynamo to destroy that. As they seem like they don't like the Skybridge game as much, though they are pushing 4 on the top now. This entire area is gone. Wait, was this because of TNT running? I don't know. Was it TNT running, or on the other team, or was it the part of the defense, this whole front line destroyal? They should just, like, half slab it all now, and then, like, fences, and make it into a DTC. Or no, not a CTW defense. And then, like, hide the wall, and then totally ignore the monument, try to trick the other team into thinking it's a wall room. Like, build a wall room to trick the other team. And then they'll sneak behind and just break the monuments while they try to get to the wall room and get back. Try to run back with the monument. Or the core. Capture the core. It'll be interesting. Like, you had to leak out the core and you have to grab the lava from inside of it and bring it back. I'd watch that.
Hold on. I thought something broke there.
It didn't. FlameBreaths have really been pushed backwards. They are all having to bunch up hidden. Not very optimal for their defense. Thanks. Yeah, I don't see much happening.
This is boring.
Because a lot of the time I don't commentate play-by-play, I commentate tactically. There aren't really many tactics going on, nothing new. Just kind of the mid-game pain loop kind of stuff before the Desperate City comes in. There's quite the large water cube here. I think it's mildly excessive, but it should be very good. Hope to see more water cubes underneath. Underscore Naomi. Trying to go for the core here. Probably won't get it, as most mid to late game cores never actually get leaked. All the cores I've seen are been very quite early game. At least I think. I can't think of any other ones. And underscore Naomi just flops into the void. Taking care of himself for the team. What's this arc cannon do? Let's see, it shoots, it's not very useful anymore. Looks like these are close to these two skybridges are close to reconnecting. I like these connected textures. It makes the glass look very nice. Connected textures are good. I heard something down here. Let's see what happened. Did you do it? Who's this guy? Anubis. I blame Anubis. Just kidding. Some sort of cannoning. Trying to counter that arc cannon, I believe. Ooh, and the whip cannon is back in service. Nowhere really shoot it at. Let's see. I guess some of these backlight. Ooh, this chest. What's in this chest? Iron armor. Take that. that out, that'd be swell, but really, not that much iron armor. If that was like a chest full of diamonds, and they blew that up, that'd be a very, very major event. Just normal TNT landing on the bedrock. No matter how many times you try, you're never gonna break the bedrock. So, I'm sorry. Oh, he's probably breaking this, that's why. Sorry for emptying so much. Up here, we have these guys. Sorry for eating from my microphone. I'm really hungry. Because I have to spend all this time with you guys. I'll come back.
Some water.
Gotta drink some water too. My vocal cords nice and well, I guess. Dynamo, FlameBreaths. Really, just the arrow fight now. 3v3. No new advances on the sky bridge. Arc cannon to try to take them out. Not really successful. Tiny bit of success by flame breaths. I wouldn't be surprised to see some slight progress back onto the sky bridge. This defense hasn't been worked on very much. It's not nearly elaborate as the core defense of flame breaths. Though Dynamo's defense does seem to work adequately. Uh, 35 minutes remaining in this match. People are firing arc cannons back. Arc cannons are always fun. They're really fun to make. You just kind of go like, pew, pew. You just make a little tiny area. You make this really powerful cannon. So I have to make like a big Icarus like this one. This thing's just weird. I don't understand it. Over here, someone falling to their death. Just an average day. They're really being pushed back onto their island. I was not expecting. I was really thinking Flame Breaths could take some back with the combination of this arc cannon, but it is unmanned right now. Really love to see this. Oh, there's a fence there, that's why I can't get out. This be worked more in combination with this. Oh, he fell to his death. However, strategy by Flame Breath. They're starting to add CTW defense style, just like I jokingly talked about before, and it actually is working not badly. Touch right here. I don't think he's gonna get anywhere. Maybe tunnel it out? Tunnel it until this air pocket, but the air pocket will probably then be filled up. Now here is probably out of radius. Sorry for eating again. I feel bad. No, you guys don't like it. FlameBreaths. Kind of taking partial retreat stand, but just waiting for reinforcements on the skybridge. Ooh! One guy versus two guys takes them both out, but then the other two get them back. Very effective use of a naked guy, though. FlameBreaths is making their move. However, it does not look to be successful. One guy continued. He's probably lower on health than the others. Oh, they can out. FlameBreaths takes this part of the skybridge. This guy really should get some more armor on. Because he's wasting diamonds not to have other easy to get armor. So I do not like that call. The FlameBreaths just decided to blow it up and play defensive. Even though they are behind in this match. They may not know it, but they are. Actually, they probably do know it, because they know that they have the other completion.
Buy a toaster. Don't bring ads to the party. Get uninterrupted music with Spotify Premium. Try it free.
Sorry. Really tired. No ads, no I'm the only one on this match. So I'm glad I didn't bet my raindrops on this, because I would have had my bet on FlameBreaths. Actually, technically, I'm not supposed to bet this. I'm an unbiased person. Well, technically, I never chose a side. It just IQ offered me that side. I was considering taking it. Maybe they will take some last minute tackle. We're only rounding around halfway through. Packed ice core mode is coming up after the break. I may monetize my videos soon, my YouTube videos though, so if I do say that sometime, maybe I did put a break there. You don't really know, do you? Well, I don't really know. You do know. Well, you live people don't know, but YouTube people will know, and I will not know at this current point in time. This weird time lag, though. Doing something live and recorded at the same time is very odd. Oh, Dynamo is trying to take back some offensive skybridge position. That thing hit me in the face. It's not working, however. Pretty sure this is gonna be all 60 minutes, sadly, because I'm really tired. Sorry for complaining, but I'm using 1.8 because why am I using 1.8? It's because I just wanted the newest version of Optifine, I guess. Maybe, I don't know, it was the newest versions, and I just downloaded the easy to grab Optifine, which was 1.8. FlameBreaths have taken that skybridge down. They are trying to blow it up, and he's going to use his diamond armor doing that. Bad call on him. He's also never fully suited up. Also a waste of diamond armor. How many diamonds do they have left? Let's see. Holy crap, totally unwatered diamonds right here. No one seems to care. Someone really should care about that. Yeah, I don't think they have very many diamonds. Unless I'll check some chests and spawn or And let's see, none there. Let's see, common. Nope, I don't see any. So, they are low on diamonds. Or maybe they stored some down here.
Nope, I don't know.
They should definitely serve the diamond, as 27 minutes are left in the match, and they are running dangerously low. Dynamo sells quite a bit of diamond, and a lot of people in diamond too. Let's check their supply chest. They have a bit of diamonds, not really anything. Three is not going to make a difference in the long run. Oops, I unplugged my headphones on accident. Right, monument for FlameBreaths. That's right here. Two people on it. Let's see. They did damage that three blocks in total compared to before. Still not enough to stack up against Dynamo. Yeah. I guess Dynamo is probably gonna win this one. Unless FlameBreaths makes a serious style comeback. Because the previous match I was in was Game 1-1 versus Sirius. Game 1-1 was up by a lot, but quite a bit the entire match. And then Sirius completed a monument, and then they kept taking the lead and had two completed and core touch. Game 1-1 only not went to boom by two blocks. That one, the melonade, or Melly, I'll just call him Melly. Melly was standing on. Ooh, another touch over here. FlameBreaths. And the other. I will not be streaming any tonight. Because I think this is the last one tonight. I'm gonna check. Yeah, this is my last one for today. However, next week, week 3, we still don't know all the matchups, so. That's one potential. Oh, there's a whole bunch of potential matches I'll be streaming, and I will probably be streaming next week. Same times, I guess. Week 3. Better teams will start to face more better teams. So finally, we will get to week 5. In the great week 5 matchups of who will take the top 2 seeds. So pretty much only 2 teams can take the top 2. Not 100% sure about that. Don't quote me on it. There's nothing really to stream from here on out. Well, I guess I could go to another match after this. But next week I'll be there for probably the evening one, unless it's the earlier time slot. The earlier, what is it, there's like the 5:20, the 4 p.m. East Coast time slot, I probably won't be there to stream next week. But that's only if people get scheduled then. more pushes by Dynamo. They don't really need pushing. Only 20-ish minutes left.
I forgot to have my Twitch up. Sorry, people,
if you're saying anything. FlameBreaths, however. They will need, they need their offense to, you know, group together. They are down one person. Quite often I see the teams that are down people often do poor, very poorly, as that one extra person could be one extra finish off in a battle, or one extra cannon you're countering, one extra person on defense. I've seen team that had six, they started with eight and they went down to six, that they had to skim off some defenders because they literally did not have enough players. So very very, very disadvantaged. However, I think they were back up. They're back up to 10. Which is good for them. It's not fun when it's not fair, but now it's pretty even. We have Dynamo jumping down. If they get a core leak here, it won't be very hard to end this match early. He gets seen. Dynamo player gets seen. Who's that? That is Naomi. Naomi? Naomi? I don't know.
I'm sorry. I can't pronounce your name properly.
Because there's so many odd names in the world and I can't memorize them all beforehand. Ooh. Here. The guy jumped out of nowhere. Wrecked him. Well, to be fair, he was low on health. This whip cannon is still going crazy. Let's see what fires on now. Just all over the place. Ooh! Core touch for Dynamo is in down here somewhere. Let's see, will it go anywhere? Wait, am I on the right side? I'm not on the right side. But yeah, I was on the right side. Sorry. My caps on. He's on the top, however. Top's a lot harder to maneuver in terms of a core leak. He's getting all them pieces, though. Trying to get down. I say hop out real quick and hop into here, but he probably can't see that. Not sure. Oh, do they not spawn with X's on this map? Forgot about that. He doesn't have an X. He can make the X. He has enough diamonds. He brought 12 extra diamonds over. That's kind of stupid. Maybe it was an accidental mine of an extra. Someone else dropped some. Toss for Dynamo. They know where he is. And dead. A lot of stuff is sizzling. What's sizzling? I think his stuff is continuing to glitch into lava, but then it's not actually there, so it gets glitched back. Well, it gets teleported back by PGM. But it's all doing that over and over, so it makes this nice sizzling noise. Much fun.
How long is my stream in? That's a decent amount.
Oh, there's someone in there. FlameBreaths doing their best to defend, however. Ooh. Oh, yeah, here it is. That, yeah. Trying to do their best to defend, however. Really, they need to be on offense at this point.
I know.
I'm not very confident in FlameBreaths' ability to at least even complete an objective at this point. My opinion, they're being too defensive. They need to go on offense and force Dynamo to start to play defensive for the rest of the match. And then hopefully FlameBreaths would then be able to get some ground on them and start attacking. They have to be lucky, though. But to start all that, they really should go on a more aggressive offensive campaign right now. FlameBreaths does have the Skybridge, which does help them a lot. I think this defense is a little... Let's see. I think it's good overall. Well, it used to be good. However, the problem now is there's so many random blocks. If it was clean-faced, most people wouldn't find the iron block in their inventory. Mine three down, first off. Find the iron block in their inventory and then place the iron block above them. They'd probably try to block in on top of it, then mine down. So you probably see them before or see some signs. However, the problem with this is, as people mine it, they're not cleaning up the surfaces and taking out those blocks. Which just makes it no longer effective to have all these extra blocks around. So, to prove this, I'd say clean up the sides, clean up any extra blocks, make it all same. So it's pretty easy to say yes, there are people in here, or no, there are not people in here. And FlameBreaths does get a touch, which is good start for them. I wouldn't say this is the entire table turn, but they need the touch may help in the future. At least they got that starting ground in. It's Alvaro pillaring up. Trying to do some sort of... I think he's... Will he operate? I don't know what he's doing here. It's a very awkward pillar. That's why I pointed it out in the first place. He's just pillaring up to get to this whip here. Cannon, then. It's not just... not an actual whip. It's not gonna whip... take that cannon to start whipping people. That'd be funny. But I guess you could also argue that the effects of this cannon are, like, FlameBreaths. Very, very effective. Skybridge. Dynamo takes back Skybridge. At this point, they should not be offensive on the Skybridge at all. They really need to take that guy there. Who just jumped down? Was that it's Goku? Or was it Naomi? One of those two. They just jumped down and died. It was not effective. They really should have been up here rebuilding a platform to defend and stop FlameBreaths from attacking. I'm not saying that Dynamo should go full defense everyone sits on back lines. That's like minute to go style. But they should, the offense that they do use should be to take back key points, to tip it in the favor of Dynamo instead of having Flame Breaths this and give potential attacking runes. So really they're defending by offending, as I've said
before in the stream.
And that last player probably would have made the difference there. Dynamo does take partial of it back, part of it back. Holding it here would be a good choke point, like blowing up this platform and expanding over here. Like that. The sky bridge is going to become a key point for any last minute rushes, because it's an easy way to get over fast without having to worry about mainly being shot off if you own it. However, the problem with why Game Mode 1 also lost is that they lost the sky bridge and then they had trouble getting over. Like, the last minute rush, only half the people actually made it to the monument. And then it was too late. Because, well, they just couldn't defeat enough people. And
it took longer.
Even then, they did have one person in it, but then they couldn't find the box, so. Sky bridges make all the difference in this map, in my opinion. But late game, sky bridges are very handy. All game they are, but the close late game really make the difference. And that arc cannon is doing a very nice shot onto that pillar. Let's see, anyone else? Observer, where is it? Hey, oh, it's there. Yeah, that's very, very effective. Just one or two more of those shots and take away a massive Saba. With a very nice long distance arc. Oh, that was a nice shot. What's this? It's Goku, really should carpet bomb that. Nice man. You listen to me. You're gonna need a listen torch. Or a button, but that's not very effective. Or that.
She's gonna, like, go backwards. Just not gonna deal with it.
I don't think that arc is gonna get much more. Maybe longer fuse, slight less angle. I don't know if they can change it that much. I like the trapdoor angling system. It's very fun. Switch it back and forth between high and low. Good for maps like, I think Iris, the up and down vertical area.
It's very good.
But I never got to use it. Way back in Breaking Core. It's because we lost to Mind Core. Because of their rush. And ultimately
made us not go to Invitationals, but
there is a map schedule
on here. There you go.
Twitch chat, by the way. Yeah, it's looking grim for Flame Breaths. Rounding 8 minutes very soon. No sort of new pushes. Need, what is that, 15 plus 10, 25 blocks to get both. Well, that means they need 20 to catch up, 20 blocks of Monument to catch up. Even then. It's just not going to be good for them.
Goku trying to hold this. He should not lose his... There, he did not lose his diamond to them. Very strategic.
strategic play there. Let's see. Dynamo was barely able to hold up with some last-minute reinforcements after Itsukaku sacrificed himself to hold off a bit, losing that diamond set. CG, do you have TT? It's not. I was thinking he should go well. This but probably more effective shooting than breaking. Ooh, where did that come from? Probably that same arc cannon. Let's go check it. Yep. Very, very effective. And it blew up a bit more. Dynamo is starting to use their initial cannon dominance, which kind of faded away because no one used cannons to really benefit the slate. Sorry, the slate game offense. What's happening down here? Ooh, they have diamonds still. That's shocking. Whoa. Something exploded. Fail Icarus? Why are they even Icarusing now? Don't do it, man. You're returning 5 minutes to go. You really don't need any offensive pushes. You just need to hold key points and not let anyone destroy your objectives or leak your car, you know that. Here. That was odd. Oh, no, little thing's back. You stream people will know. I think maybe some YouTube people if you watch all my videos, but the little thing. It was gone for a while. It's really annoying. Maybe if I do that. If I do that, that, nope. Maybe it has to do with my texture packs. I don't know. I'll have to deal with it later. Not much going on. FlameBreaths trying to get this sky bridge. It's really not going well for them now. Yeah. FlameBreaths are just destroying one of their own. What? Why did they destroy it? That was one of their own. That was stupid. They really should not have destroyed that bridge. They needed that bridge. I was getting confused, didn't I? Twitch chat. Yeah, 5 hours, I think, yeah. Because here it's 8. Where I, in my neck of the woods. I didn't have to wake up that early this morning, but I really had to set up stuff. Hello, person. Hello, Elite Fox 5. Yeah, Dynamo. Yeah, this is pretty much it. That sky bridge. The fact that Dynamo holds the aerial advantage everywhere, whether it be bow or carpet bombing, it really is helping. Dynamo seal their victory. And I see very, very little way that FlameBreaths could come back. It would have to be an amazing comeback, better than any comeback before, probably. Except maybe some of the CSGO comebacks, those are pretty good, but... This is Minecraft, it's a little harder. That amazing stuff. Show through. Amazing, super fast bridging. Let's see. It's dead. Another naked across. Nearing 1 minute left, right about now. Yeah, I don't think FlameBreaths stands a chance. I don't actually play CSGO. I just watched a few of the highlights, and it's pretty amazing that those people can react that fast. I'm just like, what happened? I have no idea what happened. But the thing is, like, here in Minecraft, you never see amazing, like, in many of these tournaments, you don't see a 4v1 or like a 5v1v1 to then go win the match very often, because the whole broken mechanics aspect of PvP. However, in a lot of other fight games, it's very possible. And GG. At least from what I've seen. Thank you for watching. This is the end for this YouTube video and my stream for the day, as I have nothing else scheduled, I believe. So, take care. Have a great day.